everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jyoti Dogra and this is the tarot spread for the zodiac sign of Scorpio. So watch if you're a Scorpio sun, moon, rising or Venus, or you're dealing with a Scorpio sun, moon, rising or Venus. So this is going to be a love and career spread. Stick around if you want to watch the same. If you want to have a personalized reading, you can book an appointment for the same on the links mentioned in the description box below. And you can also follow me on my Instagram. Anyway, so coming back to the reading, we have the Five of Swords in your past position. Then we have the Three of Wands and the Knight of Pentacles in the present position and the Queen of Wands in the future position. Now, Five of Swords definitely come with something called as backstabbing, cheating, you know, these all things come with the energy of Five of Swords. So this definitely shows me that you are stuck in a relationship, or rather I should say you are stuck in a cycle of you know, where you do not know and you're just fighting endlessly and you do not know where this is going to end. So that is something which I see for you. You both are just fighting endlessly just to put your points across and nobody is listening to what the other person is telling. So if you both will be just putting your points across and nobody is going to listen, the fight is not going to go anywhere and you will never reach a point of conclusion. So that is I see for people who are in a relationship. For people who are single, you have been repeating your past mistakes. Even now, you have nothing learned from your past mistakes. You have not learned any lesson and you are feeding on the same cycle and you keep on repeating the same mistakes that you did in your past relationship. So that's something I see for you. So you should spend less time worrying about what others think or feel about you. Rather, you should go and get things done and you should try to be more productive in your life rather than simply fighting and, you know, not going anywhere. So that's not going to help. Okay, you should also involve into something productive in your life rather than, you know, just repeating the same mistakes and then going nowhere. So that's something which comes out with the Five of Sword energy. This also means that you might be dealing with an air sign, that's Gemini, Libra or Aquarius, who might have done this thing to you, or you are doing this to them. So it can go either ways. Okay, so that's what I see for you. What you have to see is that you should be able to express yourself in a relationship, and that too in a meaningful way. Okay, you should not be just putting your points onto the other person and not listening to them, because then it's not going to help. Okay, you are just either focusing too much on their faults or they are doing that to you, and that's why it's not leading anywhere. So rather than focusing on each other's faults, you should better try to find a common denominator and how things could work in your life. Okay, you should also consider whether or not, you know, this fighting is going to help you, because if you're fighting and there is no cause of fighting, there is no use of fighting, getting it? So whenever we fight for something, we should see what we can get out of that fight. I mean, what could be the end result? And that should be something productive in life. So that's what I see for your recent past. And this reading is from May 6th to May end. If you don't know, if I haven't already mentioned, so I'm just telling it again. Then in the present position, we have Three of Wands and the Knight of Pentacles. Now, Three of Wands can indicate a travel. It could mean online dating, okay? And Knight of Pentacles is someone coming with a very genuine offer. So after you have had this phase where you guys are just endlessly fighting and nothing is going anywhere, and for people who are single, they are just repeating their past mistakes. If you let go of those things, then you can have a genuine offer from an earth sign coming or a fire sign coming towards you. Okay, and this person will not be very, very attractive. This person is not going to be very social, very party animal kind of person as you guys are, because Scorpios are that sort of people. They are very, you know, they are very passionate people, but this Knight of Pentacles is not that passionate kind of a person. He's or she is more of a down-to-earth kind of a person, but they are going to be very, very committed in a relationship, okay? So that's what I see for you. And Three of Wands, it's also telling me that the relationship that you will be having, it's not going to instantly get into something. This is the budding relationship, okay? This is going to get, this is going to be a budding relationship where you are meeting each other a few times, few dates and everything, and then you are deciding something. But because Three of Wands is clarified by Knight of Pentacles, this relationship can get into something meaningful, but the effort has to be made. If you will be just taking a back seat where you are not putting the efforts, then nothing will work out, okay? So the key is to make efforts to show the other person that you want something committal in a relationship. You don't want something casual, maybe that you have had in the past, okay, where you did not go anywhere, the relationship did not lead anywhere. And if you're in an existing relationship, then this is the time that you should be setting boundaries for each other. And try to convince, try to be very, very open about your communication to your partner that you want something committed And the Knight of Pentacles is all about commitment and a very slow offer. However, this is going to take a lot of time because Knight of Pentacles is a very slow energy. So it's going to take a lot of time. But this is something that can develop into a higher level of commitment, definitely, okay? And for others of you who are already in a relationship, you will see a new side of a person that you never experienced, maybe because they were very manipulative, but now they will be very committed. So that could be a new side that you see, because Three of Wands is again about growth. You can see these leaves growing out here. So yeah, it's about growth, it's about experiencing a new newness in a relationship, expanding your horizon. So that's all which comes with it. Okay, and with Knight of Pentacles, this can also mean that you might be meeting someone while traveling, or maybe while shifting places, or at a job environment, because Knight of Pentacles is all about travel and shifting, or so that kind of thing. And Knight of Pentacles can also mean that if you are already in a relationship, so you both will be working towards improving your finance and career. So in your present relationship, I see most of you guys are not really focused about relationship. You are rather focused more about your professional growth, okay? You guys are more focused about your career right now rather than relationship, okay? And then Three of Wands could be a Sun in Aries kind of a person. So it's definitely a Sun in Aries. That's mean in Aries, as I said, there could be an Earth sign or a Fire sign, okay? So that's what I see for you. And then we have Queen of Wands in the future position. So Queen of Wands is someone who is very very independent, is very popular, is someone who is very easily liked, very attractive and fun kind of a person, okay? And by the way, Knight of Pentacles with Three of Wands can also show a very creative career. So some of you are in a very creative career, and Queen of Wands is again about creativity. So you are very much focused about your career, being creative, being very social, going out, meeting people, being very independent. So that's all the energy that I get here. Okay, and if you want to pursue a relationship, so Queen of Wands is someone who will go behind whatever he or she likes, okay? So this energy is someone who is very passionate, okay? So if they want, they are a very go-getter kind of a person. So if you want this relationship, you have to be very, very, you have to be someone who is putting a lot of efforts, okay? You have to be very consistent about it. So that's what I, conclude. And if you're already single, then this is the time to go out, to meet people, to have that fun quotient in your life back, okay? And creativity is going to be a very important factor right now, okay? And then at the bottom of the deck, we have the Six of Wands, which again shows being very social, going out, partying and everything, and creativity. So right now, I think more than love, it is all about being creative, being social, and meeting people, and involving yourself into creativity. And then Nine of Wands, be careful of this Nine of Wands energy, because this could be someone who is very in and out. Nine of Wands is a type of relationship that person will come in very quickly and will leave very quickly. So that's not something that you want in your relationship. And then we have the Seven of Pentacles. So Seven of Pentacles shows me that someone is working really hard on their career. And if you are in a relationship, you are working really hard to get that stable relationship, and that could be with an earth sign, and that could be maybe during, as I said, shifting places or at a workplace or something of that sort. And then we have the Death card, which is your card. So a lot of transformation is going on. You have to transform yourself before you get to the stable person or you get to the stable career. Then we have the Knight of Pentacles. Knight of Pentacles is again an earth sign coming, who is very stable and who is very committed. So that's what I see for you. Now I'm gonna pull some cards from my Romance Angel deck. Okay, hold on a minute for any love messages for you people. So this is my new setup, by the way. I've got a new setup for reading cards. Okay, so any messages for my Scorpio Sun, Moon, Rising or Venus for love? Ooh, okay, so we have past life relationship. So some of you are very much stuck in your past life relationship, or maybe someone might be coming back from the past, but then it is clarified by pay attention to the red flags. So you have to pay attention to the red flags, as I say, that Knight of Wands kind of energy. Any more messages for my Scorpio Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus for love in May 2019? Okay, we have a lot of cards. So we have children. So children might be affecting your love life right now. Some of you are married and having children and maybe looking for someone else, or someone else is having children, that's affecting your love life. Then we have engagement. So for some of you, as I said, that Knight of Pentacles and that King of Pentacles, so something committal is definitely coming into your way. Your love life is ascending to a higher level of commitment. If you will put that effort, it is safe for you to love this, maybe this very committal person who is coming towards you. It's safe, if it is safe to love, and this could be the one. So for some of you, that could be the person. Okay, so that's your love reading. If you want to have a career reading, you can stick around. Otherwise, thanks for watching. Now I'm gonna pull some messages from my tea leaf fortune cards here. It's an amazing deck. Comes with this bag for shuffling. Just a minute. Let's see. Scorpio, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus for career, May 2019, please. Okay, so we have a lot of cards. So we have X, which shows forces working against you, and we had the red flags also. So someone is definitely working against you. Then we have Leg, which shows stepping into a new experience. So some of you will be having that new experience at your career. Then tree is affairs with your family. Some of you will be going to meet your family, or family might come to meet you. Then we have dragon, which shows be aware of self-delusion. Beware of self-delusion. You're not, unnecessarily creating a hype about yourself. And it's very important to know yourself first, okay? Then we have clouds, which shows some temporary problems in your career. We have triumph over trouble and obstacles. So definitely you will be getting the triumph, because we also had the six of wands, I think seven of wands card. Then we have mountain road, which shows you are on the road to success. So in your career, I think career looks really good. Then you have the angel, which shows spiritual guidance, protection from a harm. And then lastly, we have the teapot card, which shows deep friendship with someone of the same sex. So someone of the same sex at your career might be having a deep friendship with you, or you might have with them. I mean, obviously. Friendship is about you. So yeah, that's your reading. If you enjoyed the reading, let me know in the comment section below if it resonates. Otherwise, thanks for watching. I will see you in the next video. You guys take care. Bye.